Today, we're going to talk a little bit about science, but I'm going to start with a little background that might be a little bit remedial for this group, because if you're here at South by Southwest, you're probably familiar with large language models. But to make a large language model, you basically show it all the internet. Millions of books, billions of websites, and it discovers how people think and speak because it's able to make associations between what it sees, what you've shown it. You can ask it a question in plain English, and most of the time, it gives you a pretty good answer. It's been amazing to see this happen over the past few years. But what if you took that AI model and instead of showing it all the information that people have put out into the world, what if instead you pointed it inwards and showed it what's inside each one of us? What if you showed an AI model 3D images of the human heart at an atomic level? What if you showed it videos of individual cells interacting with other cells? What if you taught it the molecular code and all the structures inside every one of your cells? What you would get is a powerful simulation of how the human cell works. And at the Chan Zuckerberg Initiative, we call that the virtual cell model. And we think a virtual cell model would completely change the way we understand health and medicine. We know a little bit about cells. For the non-biologists in here, let's do a little background. Remember, cells, they are the smallest unit of life. If you remember high school biology, the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. DNA, that lives in the nucleus. But I'm not exaggerating when we understand some more, but not that much more about how a cell works. There's a lot happening. There are trillions and trillions of cells. It's really hard to study those individual components of the cell, and it's nearly impossible to understand how those components come together for a functioning system. And the wet lab, in the lab, we can only zoom in on the tiniest of windows. So we need the large language model and we need these digital simulations to be able to understand how the smallest unit of life actually comes together and creates us. The hope is then with those models, we'll be able to answer some of the hardest questions in biology. How do we, from a single genome, create neurons and fingernails? How do we know which cells are the same and which ones are different? What does each gene actually do? And what happens when there's errors in them? And how do those trillions of cell types come from a single fertilized egg to make each one of your unique selves? Those are the deepest, oldest questions in human biology. And if a virtual cell can help us answer those questions, we will be so much closer to actually cure and preventing disease, heart disease, neurodegeneration, cancer, maybe all disease. So I want to take the next hour or so to imagine if every scientist and physician had access to a virtual cell model, what would they do? How would life change for all of us? I'll share three quick ideas right now, and then Emily and I will get into it for the rest of the hour. The first idea, I think, is everyone's natural instinct. I want to know about me. We live in an age of personalization. My algorithm knows I like pop music, skiing, and stand-up comedy. And so I expect it to treat me as an individual And I would be really disappointed if we all shared the same reels. But right now, because of how hard it is to do science, that's basically what happens. We study a very small and limited number of samples, and we extrapolate from there to everyone else, whether or not they are represented in the original sample set. But if we build the right data and AI models, we can better understand what specifically keeps each one of us healthy and what makes each one of us sick. So here's what we're working at the Chan Zuckerberg Initiative. Build a virtual cell that can understand the variations across the genome. Use it to predict the unique physiology of each one of our bodies. Learn about what health problems we're susceptible to and how we will uniquely respond to different types of interventions. My doctor would want that. I would want that. That brings me to the next idea, which is discovering new treatments. Right now, the drug discovery process is incredibly difficult. It usually takes decades of trial and error and billions of dollars of investments. And even the successes, they can be derailed by terrible side effects. Side effects that are discovered way too far into the drug discovery process because we just don't understand how the drugs affect non-target tissues and organs. And that process completely misses patients of rare disease, whose populations are so small that the math simply doesn't pencil out for research and drug development. A virtual cell changes that equation. Rather than testing candidate molecules one by one in the lab, you can model the disease in the software. You can test a million potential therapies. You can screen out drugs that don't reach your target tissue, that aren't commercially viable, and that harm other tissues. And in the end of the process, you have a handful of really promising candidates to test in the lab. And in that world, you can compress years of work into days. Your success rate goes way up, and the costs, hopefully, go way down. You can develop more drugs for patients, and those drugs, probably for most diseases, will be way better. And I know that's exciting. And on that note, this is the one I'm actually most excited about. Here's another idea. The most powerful defense system for ourselves is not actually drugs. It's actually the human immune system. We usually think about it as a way that we fight off bacteria or viruses, but it actually does so much more. No other drug therapy comes close. But even our immune system has limits. Oftentimes, detecting certain types of tumor cells is really hard because it evades our human immune system. Tumors hide from it. And so by the time we develop symptoms, the damage is oftentimes significant and irreversible. But you know how large language models can write poems? What if we could use it to engineer a new type of cell? You could say this: I need a cell that can roam in my body and detect if there are signs of a certain type of tumor. And if it does detect that type of tumor, can you write that into the cell's own code so that information has been recorded? That technology actually already exists. We just need to build it in a targeted way. So with a large language model, you could reverse engineer that immune cell that you're looking for, step by step, gene by gene. And you could go even further. You could give an engineered cell the power to both go in and detect the disease and then go in and take care of it. That would put us in a world where we aren't just trying to treat disease when it's out of control. We're actually preventing it at the earliest stages. No one knows for sure if this is possible. That's the disclaimer. But I think this, my bold claim is that we can be in this future in the next 20 years, and a lot of it in the next 10 years. The reason I believe this is because health and medicine, it moves in leaps. There are decades when research gets stuck. And then someone invents a new technology that completely changes how we see the human body. And it just, it gives us a stark before and after. And I believe we're in the process of moving between that before state and the after state. And I have such strong conviction in that because it has happened over and over again in history. My favorite example, the microscope. Before the microscope, we could see what we could see with the naked eye and look for patterns. Afterwards, we could actually see microorganisms. We could see the smallest bits that make you who you are, and we could do something about it. We understood a lot more about health. X-rays and MRIs, they allowed us to see inside a living body. And then the DNA sequence revolution gave us the blueprint of life. All those technologies put us in a stark state of before and after. And I believe virtual cells can be a breakthrough technology just like those. And at CZI, we've built some early models. I'm biased, but I believe that we are set up to give scientists new tools to see the world completely differently. And they're going to be able to look at the world and understand the cellular basis of health and disease. Right now, so much is a mystery. Why do millions of us wake up with chronic pain? What really causes depression? I think we're the generation, the first people in history, who get a chance to actually find out and do something about it.